My name is Marva Archibald, and I am your moderator for this evening. As you can see, we've got some jazz music for you to relax and enjoy the evening while you mingle and sample ethnic food that's provided for you in the back. Be sure to try the variety of punch that we have as well. All right, on your table, you will see an evaluation form, and we provided a pen for you. We asked that as we move through the program, that you will make notes on the evaluation form. Our goal is to make it bigger and better every year, so we value your feedback, so please do. You may also see some diversity notepads. We were trying to get quite a few done, but our schedule has been hectic. We were not able to do that. So if you feel the need to have a notepad to scribble on or to take for future use, please go ahead and do so. All right? Do you have any questions? That's coming from a teacher. If you don't, we're going to go ahead and get started. Dr. Larson, I'm going to invite her to the podium. Thank you.
Thank you, Marva. Marva is the chair of the diversity committee at Edison State, and let's give her a round of applause. All of her work and leadership, but this event in particular is one that she focuses on every year. And I have to say, this is just the best turnout that we have had. It is fantastic to see our tables full. And as Marva said, next year, you know, more tables and more participation. It is wonderful that people came out for this event for this evening. So it is my pleasure to welcome you to our Black History Month event on behalf of the Board of Trustees of Edison State Community College, on behalf of our faculty, staff, and administration, and again on behalf of myself and my husband Len Larson. We welcome you to the campus. We are glad that we see multi-generations here. We welcome families and children and adults and everyone who is here this evening. Diversity in all of its beauty is what it is about, and about what this event is about as well. We do have an interesting program for you this evening. I want to first thank our sponsors of the event. So this event is sponsored by Unity National Bank, sponsored by U.S. Bank, Edison State, and the Diversity Committee. Can I get the sponsors, Marva? And at this time, I would like to ask those in attendance who are part of the Edison State Diversity Committee to please stand. Can you please give them a round? On your program, you do have the list of the upcoming events from the Diversity Committee. We do try to have something every month or multiple things during the month. And always, always, the public is invited to these events. They are always free of charge. And we would encourage you to please come and take advantage of them. Bring your friends and family. They are always open to the public. And they are always of very high quality. Our committee makes sure of that. This evening, this year, we decided to really, and we planned this event very far ahead. But it could not be, I don't think, a better time to really reflect, to calm our minds, to reflect on beauty in art and music, and maybe take a moment to cease with words and looking at what is happening in terms of conflict and confusion, and to look into our minds and our hearts and really see the beauty that has been created by mankind, the beauty that is around us, and the beauty that is possible through human interaction and human endeavor. We see many things that are not beautiful. This evening is a focus on beauty, beauty in art, beauty in music, the beautiful words of our talented students. So I hope that people this evening, that you will take a breath, calm your minds, reflect, and enjoy. And so first we have for you a selection from our quartet. And we welcome them this evening, the Speaking of Peace Jazz Quartet, and they have the first selection, so enjoy.
Actually, our drummer had to step out for a quick emergency.
Always the drummer.
Good evening, everybody. Since we have a quick second here, I'll take a quick second to introduce three of the members of the band. On piano, we have the, I don't even know what adjectives to use, but one of our, we have two master musicians up here, period, but we have Tucky Bailey, who is a phenomenal, legendary piano player. We have one of my mentors, Mr. Eddie Brookshire, on bass. Like I said, our percussionist will be right back. He had a brief family emergency, we'll call real quick. My name is Mbikele G. Scott Jones, and I play the trombone. And our percussionist is Mr. Before I say who he is, this is like my brother. We traveled, when we got to know each other, actually, we were in South Africa. I think we met a little bit before we went, didn't we? A little bit before, yeah. But then we got to know each other across the world, which was really cool. So this is Mr. Matt Green, my brother. So we're gonna play a couple, are we doing one or a couple right now? Just one right now? Okay, so we're gonna do a piece. We're gonna do one that we're gonna ask for you all, if you don't have food in your mouth right this second, to respond. The chant or the mantra, if you will, is peace and love, this is what we are. So I'm gonna point at everybody with this gesture and go ahead and do it. It doesn't have to be exactly lined up, just peace and love, this is what we are. If you're eating, eat. And if you say, how long do we do this? We do this until you don't feel like doing it anymore. Okay? So you don't have to keep going forever, but just whenever it feels right, just stop until I bring you back in. Okay? Peace and love. This is what we are. Peace and love. This is what we are. We all learn quickly. Peace and love. This is what we are. Let's keep that going for a little bit. Thank you. So that one was an original. This next one is actually dedicated to my wife. She's an Aries, so it's called Aries Rising. She thinks it sounds angry. I think it sounds pretty good. Anyway.
No. Well,
we'll be right back.
Thank you.
Competition. We started in October, November to put the entry form together to come up with the criteria we needed to share with the faculty, and then we asked them to forward the information to their students as soon as possible. We were fortunate this year to have 33 entries in the essay competition. We went, wow. All right, now how do we narrow it down to first place, second place, and third place? So we put a judge of panel together, and we asked them to take a look at the entries and narrow it down to 8. At that point, the emails kept going back and forth between the judges and myself to look not only at spelling and grammar, but also to look at content. And so from that point on, they started to focus on how they would make their selection. It was a tough task, but I believe they did it in record order. So I'm gonna ask Mr. Carlos Santos to come to the podium and name the winners for us. And then we understand that some of the winners were unable to make it this evening. So we also asked Carl to read the introduction and conclusion from those essays for the winners who were not able to make it this evening. So Carl, here we go.
Thank you, Marva. If we needed more time to fill and the wonderful musicians ran out of songs, Marva was going to do a rendition. Are you ready? Okay. But we really appreciate Marva's overwhelming organization, and now to slip a little change into it, we just adjust, as we always do as teachers, to what has to be done and fill those places. If you haven't filled your stomach yet with that wonderful food, be free to continue to do that. Our chef would be just proud to have empty dishes back there. So take advantage of that opportunity. As Marva mentioned there, we had 33, and it was quite a task. We went from about 6 the first year, maybe 8 to 10 the next year, to 33 this year. And we have some judges, Eileen Thompson, Craig Gilbert, myself. And we're wishing to expand those judges and get 66 essays next year. That'll be just wonderful all the way around. I'm going to ask our essay winners to come up. By the way, the essays are pinned to the walls back there. They have been in our gallery along with the artwork for a few weeks. And now they're pinned back there for you to read in addition to hearing from the actual authors. So I'm going to ask Shelby North to come up. And I've just met some of our writers by face tonight, as others have sometimes are online. And just to reacquaint Shelby and ourselves, we have a process here. The reading is extremely important. Obviously, that's what we're here for. And then we have the photograph, Dr. Larson. And we have a plaque provide to them, and we also have a gift certificate that will be awarded to them as well. So there's quite a number of little items that we provide here tonight. Shelby North is our third place. We're going to build up suspense. We're going to work third, first, second, first. And Shelby's going to share her essay, and you may applaud loudly when she's done for as long as you want.
Martin Martin Luther King Jr. was an icon. In the 1950s and the 1960s, he continued to show the world that civil rights did not have to result in violence. He believed that African-American men and women could one day live in peace and have equal rights. Mr. King inspired people, he drove people, whether African-American or white, to believe in a better world, but also fight for what the world, fight for that world without violence. He had the country divided. This, unfortunately, is much like today's world. It pains me to see the division again in our society. When asked to write an essay about making the world better, at first I had to ponder the topic. Then with such ease, I thought of Bobby Bones. Bobby Bones is a radio star that brings joy into everybody's lives through not just funny, but also uplifting stories. Bobby Bones is on the country radio station Monday through Friday for a few hours. It's based out of Nashville, but it's throughout the U.S. And he does a weekly sitcom called Tell Me Something Good. Each person on the show, or just Bobby himself, finds a story about something positive that happened in America. One of my very favorites is when local police officers got a call to an elderly woman's house because her family hadn't heard from her and they wanted to make sure that she was safe. After seeing she was, the police officers made breakfast with the elderly lady and sat and talked to her because they could tell that she was lonely. Each story has the same concept of how average people can do something simple to make a better day. Bobby Bones has a movement called #PimpinJoy, which is a movement which is all about choosing joy as well as spreading joy. Each year he does a week-long event in honor of his co-star's mother, Judy. Judy lost her fight to cancer a few years back, but through her fight, she still chose joy and found ways to spread it. The hashtag was created for listeners to follow Judy's journey on Twitter. Each year they do a joy week. The show sells Pimp and Joy clothing, where all the money goes to St. Jude's Hospital. This year, they happen to sell clothes and help for Hurricane Harvey relief, which was ironic because this was the first year that something in the world had been going on where they could help other than just with St. Jude. Bobby also finds ways to raise money for other charities through other types of clothing. Many find it odd that I picked Bobby Bones to talk about, a radio star. But Bobby and the cast every day make me smile at least once. In the time of judgment, terror, and division, Bobby Bones finds a way to prove that there is good in the world, and simple acts of random kindness can ignite such love in the world. Mr. King and Bobby had a lot alike in this aspect. When asked to do a Martin Luther King essay, this is the first thing that came to mind.
Shelby. She's got her whole family here tonight and the children. You've just watched your mom do a tremendous job. Someday you'll be up here reading and know what it's like to be nervous. We applaud. You're probably wondering what we're doing up here finagling around the table. Each year we learn more and more about the steps we should take. And so that was an important step there, the awarding of the gift certificate. Dr. Larson, and then signing a document for the official card presented from our bookstore. Cecilia Rice is not able to be here tonight, family emergency, and she was second place. Her teacher is Becca Lindemann from over in the Dark County campus, and I'm going to read a portion of her essay, Cecilia Rice. Pursuit of happiness has become something of a pipe dream for so many Americans. It's as much a pipe dream now as it was during the Martin Luther King Jr.'s time. While we may have progressed against segregation based on color, we find other groups being discriminated against in the same or worse ways than they were 60 years ago. The fact of the matter is we are living in more than just two Americas now. There are a multitude of other Americans that are divided based on gender, race, culture, sexual preference. Martin Luther King Jr. would be shocked and sickened at how little we've actually progressed toward his dream of being one nation, undivided. This is a long involved essay. I'm going to read the conclusion to it here so we can put it all together in this particular way. The nation is in a true crisis. The truth is we pretend it's not. We post on social media about ourselves, keeping the public eye on the Kardashians, what meals we've cooked, or cat videos. Meanwhile, there are people that are being beat because of their skin color. There are others that are being denied medical care because of gender, personal choices, and inability to pay. Others still are committing suicide, falling victim to depression due to the oppression they faced in their short lives. While we sip our tea and look the other way, injustice still takes place in America. There are still disadvantaged groups being taken advantage of and being discriminated against. There are riots happening, which Martin Luther King was actually opposed to as a result of these discriminatory conditions. Because of the little progress that seems like we have made in times as a nation against discrimination, he would be appalled, at least upset. If we took one step forward, sometimes we take two back. Again, that's Cecilia Rice. She's not with us tonight, but she did a wonderful job. So if we can applaud her and ask her. First place winner, Charity, if you'll come up here. And it's a delight to meet the lady behind this particular essay, which carried through a kind of a first place flavor through much of that judging. And so we are appreciative of her coming here tonight. She's going to read her essay for us. So I give you Charity, your worship. Charity.
My essay is called More Than Black and White. When I think of racism, a very important man comes to my mind, and that's Martin Luther King, Jr. My favorite speech that this man ever gave was the I Have a Dream speech. The speech was delivered on August 28, 1963, and Dr. King talked about how he hoped to see racism come to an end. I'd like to say that we have achieved this dream of his more than 50 years later in 2018, but sadly we have not. To this day, February 27th, 2018, we have blacks hating whites and whites hating blacks, and people being judged based on the pigment of their skin and nothing else. When I start to think about racism and how it has affected my life, I start to think about a time when I was only in kindergarten. You see, I lived in a small town my whole life, but I never really truly noticed that at a young age my skin tone was different. It was just a little bit darker than my friends. My skin color was never a problem with anyone until I entered kindergarten. As I said before, I'm from a small town where there wasn't anyone who was considered different other than hair or eye color. Everyone was the same. I never will forget the day that I was told, you shouldn't be proud to be you. It was Native American Week, where we got to learn all about culture and traditions of the Native American people. This subject had my attention because I myself am Native American. I remember telling my kindergarten teacher that I was so excited to celebrate and learn about the Native American cultures and tradition because it was half of me. Her response was something that has stuck with me since that day. With the straightest face in the world, she looked at me and said, oh, sweetheart, you shouldn't be proud to be you. You're a half-breed, and no one wants to be a half-breed. I didn't know what she meant, but I know it didn't make me feel very good. As I looked around the classroom, I noticed I was darker than the rest of the students from my hair to my skin tone. Until this point, it had never bothered me. When I went home that night, I told my mom what my teacher had said, and I asked her, why do I have to be a half-breed? Because it's something bad, and I didn't want to be anything bad. Now, I know some people may think that my example isn't truly based on racism, but ask yourself a question. If it's not racism, then what is it? If my case isn't racism, then how is anyone else's? I was told I shouldn't be proud to be me, since I am more than one race, because my skin tone is darker. I sometimes feel that people think racism is only about black and white, but it isn't that simple. I think truly people forget there are more people and more races that are truly affected. I hope hearing my story impacts all of you in the audience tonight, and that you look at racism in a different light and realize it goes deeper than black and white. In conclusion, I hope that one day Martin Luther King Jr.'s dream does come true, because I truly think America will be a much better place when it does. Thank you.
charity. I believe she had a fan club back there as we heard them screaming with delight through this entire operation here. So glad to have the glee club, the cheering group, the cheerleaders, the whole thing. Proud of your mom there. Tremendous. At least we make this quicker than the other.
Yes, we do. All righty. So, ladies and gentlemen, I bring to you Gory Drum and Dance from Columbus, Ohio. Just a little background about the group. They focus primarily on West African dance styles. They're out of Columbus. There's a large group of West Africans that reside in Columbus, and so they get together and dance all the time. They weave together the rich diversity of directors, Bala, and his wife, far-reaching experiences. Gory Drum and Dance is committed to honoring the tradition of their teachers, culture, and history of traditional West African dance while bringing their own unique flair. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Gory Drum and Dance.
Manyobe kumbolela, ala dandala. Manyobe kumbolela, ala dandala. E alma migero vale, ala dandala. Ala dandala, ala dandala. E alma migero vale, ala dandala. Misere, 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 duguvana. Misere, 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 duguvana. Thank you. How everybody doing? How everybody doing? So the first song I was singing is with unity, together. It's strong, right? That's what does that mean. So next one we're gonna do dance, African dance. And at the end, I'll make you guys dance, right? Zaminamina, eh, waka waka,
waka waka,
Zamina mina.
Zamina mina.
Zamina mina. Waka waka. Zamina mina zenkelewa. Zamina mina zenkelewa. Yeah, he's just like, give me food. It's easy. Zamina mina zenkelewa. So we go from the top, all right? Zamina mina,
Zamina mina,
Waka waka,
Waka waka,
Zamina mina zenkelewa. Yeah, you gotta win. Okay, so look, I'm gonna say it first, right? Zamina mina, waka waka, Zamina mina zenkelewa. Anawa a zambo,
zambo.
Zamina mina, waka waka, Zamina mina zenkelewa, anawa a. You say zambo,
zambo,
zambo, anawa a.
Anawa a.
Zamina mina, waka waka.
Before we do our second half, I know there are some awards before we do our second part. Any questions for us? Okay, well, we hope that you enjoy the rest of our show, and thank you again for having us.
please come to the podium. This will not take very long. We are going to go ahead with the presentation of the art winners. We've got our third place, second place, and first place winners. Okay. So we're going to get started. After that, what we will do then is have a musical selection and then the dance, and we will wind down the evening. All right? Thank you for staying with us. Yes, absolutely. On your tables, the centerpieces, we have in our midst a retired art teacher from Piqua High School, and she was the one who made the gourds on your table. So please give a round of applause.
Larry Hamilton's with us tonight. Many of you know Larry. This is his wonderful wife. The art teacher just mentioned there, Liz. And she's going to present her background on these decisions. These artists were judged by faculty here at the school and then rated in a 1, 2, 3 situation. They're translating right now.
We have third place, Brandon Kraft. And we have second place, Sarah Hayden. And we have first place, Lindsay Hayden. Woo!
And you go down the very first corridor, the 100 corridor on our campus, there's a painting there of a musician, and that also has been done by Linda and purchased by one of our foundation members as a gift to our music and art students on campus. So I hope you'll walk by and take a look at that painting as well. It's absolutely beautiful and is a beautiful addition to our campus. So we always appreciate her artwork, and again, the beautiful artwork on the tables is absolutely astounding. Thank you so very much. Thank you. And once again, we'll have a musical selection by our quartet. Thank you.
Are there any John Coltrane fans in here?
Oh, okay.
This is one of his songs for when he, they say, transitioned into the avant-garde. This thing's just a little too high. So this is a song called Spiritual by John Coltrane.
Thank you.
selection from Gori Drum and Dance. Thank you.
Oh,
the hood. Yeah, 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 head. Good night. Kalamatu, Kalamatu, like. Jamanu, 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 like. Jamkatu, Bara, Mulai, Mulai. TV, Dava, Jam.
Volunteers? Promise we won't go too fast. Just right. Come on. 3 or 4 steps, it won't kill you, I promise.
You can do it where you are too. You be shy to come in.
Oh, Robin, let's go.
Let's go. Come on, Robin.
Robin.
Yes, Miss Marva, let's go, please. No more volunteers. Good exercise.
I am an old lady.
Mm-hmm. Okay, we're going to
swim. Oh, yeah. Thank you. Yes, let's go. Let's go.
If I'm going, you have to come with me. Come on, William.
Yes, William, come on, please.
I'm sorry, why did you?
Yes, guys, please, join us. Give us some balance up here. Okay, William, I heard you got the moves. Let's go. No, too late. That's it. Nobody else wants to enjoy this experience? No? All right, here we go.
And this little quick thing, I just want everybody to give Marva a hand to say thank you. Thank you. The hymn book?
Aruba
style. Aye, Namunale. Aye, Namunale. Namunale. Namunale, Samawai, Namunala. Aye, Namunale. Aye, Namunale. Namunale. Namunala, Samawai, Namunale. Aye. Thank you. Thank you, thank you. See you next year. Thank you.
And under the leadership of Scott Dunphy, thank you. John Coltrane rocks. All right. Corey, drum and dance. We thank them for their brilliant performance as well. To ABI for preparing the ethnic meal, we thank them as well. The maintenance department for putting the room together and accommodating us in any way we needed, we thank them as well. Our sponsors, Edison State Community College, U.S. Bank of Troy, and Unity National Bank of Pickwell. We thank them. Without your support, we would not be able to put this program together. So we thank you. And in closing, I thank each and every one of you for being in the audience tonight, to be a part of it, to be engaged in the performances that we worked so hard to present to you. We thank you for coming out. We look forward to having you back next year, same place, same time. And we thank you again from the bottom of our hearts. Edison, thank you. We thank you. Lastly, if you did not get the opportunity to complete the evaluation form, we ask you kindly if you would take a few minutes to do so while we get ready to close out with, and we've also included in your program, Lift Every Voice and Sing. So the lyrics is included for you so that we can wrap up. We thank you, we thank you, we thank you for coming out, and be safe getting back to your abode. Thank you. Which one is it? We shall overcome. So, would you mind joining us? I apologize, I didn't have it in my program. Could we go ahead and rise, and we will sing that song as we are dismissed one from another.
Overcome someday. walk hand in hand. We'll walk hand in hand someday. Oh, even my heart, I do believe. We'll walk hand in hand one day.
And then we're actually doing it tonight, and I think that's a wonderful thing. And what a great job Marva has done. Let's give her a hand of appreciation. Maybe we should do this again before next year. Have a wonderful evening, everyone. Thanks for coming out and supporting us. Yeah.